Hello, I'm Jim Parkin, Senior Model Maker at Aardman Animations, and I'm here with the stars of Early Man, and we're going to have a go at a bit of hognobbing. So we have everything we need in front of us. This is your kit,
right?
And everything we need to make.
I'm going to be so bad at this.
Now, everybody says this, but with the right tuition and the right
materials. So it's all about the teacher. Blame the teacher.
Exactly. Okay. It all lies on me if it all goes wrong. So we have cocktail sticks. Now, normally we'd have a highly engineered armature. Now, we don't have the time or the budget for that today.
No CNC lathe.
So we're going to go cocktail sticks, toothpicks, whichever your preferable term is.
Yeah.
Wow, okay.
We've got white for tusks and eyeballs, a bit of black for hoofs or hooves. We're going to take our clay and we have three strips of clay.
Yes.
One,
okay.
Two, three. So the first challenge for you guys is to separate your clay.
Okay.
Not as easy as it might seem. So we're going to need two of these.
Yeah.
Okay.
Great.
And what I want you to do is squash it up.
But you did put them together first, right?
You can do whichever way you like, as long as they end up as a kind of warm clod of clay or ball of clay. That's what we're aiming for. So what we're aiming for is a kind of, I'd say, like a potato, really.
Potato.
And we all know potatoes, so we're all good with potatoes.
Yes, chef.
Yeah.
Something.
Am I right in thinking
spuddy.
We're doing the body?
We are doing the body here.
Okay, so we want to match that sort of.
Absolutely. So we're looking for something
kind
a
of like
bit,
a oval.
A little bit like that, but we're going to just flatten the end. So we've got a nice flat platform for his head. So we have a body.
Yeah.
We're going to take one of our spared no expense sculpting tools, and we're going to prong hognob with a cocktail stick.
Okay. Can I just have a little look at yours?
In the flat end.
In the flat end. Yeah, this is going to pin hognob's head on. Okay. But we don't want it too much sticking out. Otherwise,
you've
we'll
gone
end
slightly.
Up with a
I've noticed you've gone slightly lower. Sort of lower than the centre.
Lower, yeah.
There's a good reason for that.
That's
so
a good
we've got a bit more length with the snout. So we're looking for something that looks a little bit like that. But at this stage, we're not going to worry too much because funny and thummy
funny
is
and
the
thummy.
Key.
Funny
is
and
that
thummy.
Genuinely the sort of Aardman motto?
It's very much
so
Aardman
like
kind of mantra.
It's brilliant.
I'm going to use it like he said, is that what he said to you in the sound booth? Funny, funny and thummy.
Now, we have our last whole strip of clay. And what I want you to do, take it in your hands, and I'd like you to fold it end to end like so and gently press together, and it should split down the middle, leaving you with two hopefully equal bits of clay.
Oh, I've made a terrible mess.
That's quite all right.
One is shorter than the other.
Choose your favourite.
Thank you.
Everyone's got a favourite.
This one.
Choose which one you prefer. Yeah. And again, squash it with the clay, and we're going to make a sausage, a cocktail sausage. How are we looking?
Yeah,
looking
good.
Looks wonderful.
You guys are pros. This is looking good so far.
Yeah.
So what I want you to do now is take your pinching fingers, and on one end, just pinch out the top, and we're just giving
is that his brow
a
bone?
Bit of an eyebrow now, which is what we call the patented Wallace and Gromit or Nick Park monobrow.
Yeah.
It's that one piece of clay that gives a lot of emotion in our characters. And then what we're going to do is just gently tease round the front of the clay into a kind of L shape or C shape.
And thummy.
Exactly, now you're getting it.
How far? Oh, you want to go full?
Quite perky.
Oh, that's a bigger
like proper triangle. Okay.
Yeah. So we've got a nice kind of buoyant face.
Yeah.
Well, it's looking very
and a
thummy.
Cheeky snout. Now get your finger in there and just slightly flatten the end.
Yeah.
To make a nice
snout. Oh, very good.
So it's kind of you're giving away all your secrets here.
Well, this is it. This is my thing is to try and translate it for children from 5 to 95.
Oh,
how to make something close to our real creations as well.
It's weirdly satisfying.
Now we're going to pin our head onto the body. So what we want to do is just align the snout with a cocktail stick and kind of
So the cocktail stick should
together.
Go through the snout.
Yeah, preferably. So we're just going to use our fingers and the warmth of our hands just to smooth the face across onto the body. So we're melding those shapes together, really. So it's all into one lump, really. You can also use, again, our toothpicks, cocktail sticks to smooth in as well. Brilliant. So already we're starting to see something
resembling,
I think.
Absolutely.
Yeah. So we're going to put that to one side for a second.
Right.
Now, we're going to need some ears for our hognob.
Oh, yeah.
So we have this remaining clay now. Although we've got the same amount of clay and we've had the same instructions, I think it's fair to say our pigs are looking quite different to each other, aren't they? So it's going to be down to your individual pig as to how big your ears are going to be. But I'm going to take roughly that much clay. And I've got these four lines running down the clay, which really helps.
Okay.
So that means you can split it in half and have two little lumps of clay,
so
like so.
Take a little square.
Yeah. Now we're aiming for symmetry here.
Okay.
And you can see on my pre-made pig, we've got kind of leaf-shaped, or literally I want you to make a pig's ear of it. No, like, or two, okay. Preferably. So that's the real key. So again, getting the clay nice and warm. That's the real key with this. And then squashing it down.
Into
a kind of
an, a sort of oblong
leaf shape, or
yeah.
Diamond shape roughly, and then you can kind of flatten it down. We've got one ear like so, and then we want another of those as well.
Okay.
So pop your ears on.
And again, so you go downwards from here, like to smooth it.
You'd that's
go
it, like kind of drawing it together, and again,
amazing.
Use those.
That is seriously good.
It's rather good, actually, yeah.
I've never really done it before.
So again, using the cocktail sticks to help sculpt the two together. So we're aiming for nice flappy ears, a good brow, and a nice snout as well.
Are we allowed to put them in like a funny like
absolutely
way?
Absolutely, add your own character in there.
All right, adding character to yours. I was just trying to like make them vaguely resemble something.
Feeling like. Confident, I like yeah. It, it's good. So we have something that looks vaguely like this.
Yeah.
Pig-like. Now we need to add some facial features. So we can take your sculpting tool and poke your pig in the nose. Like so, go
steady
not
on.
Not too deep.
Yeah. Okay.
But like so, and just give it a little wiggle around. We need obviously a pair of nostrils.
Okay.
And now I've done this upside down, so it's hard to get symmetry, but we're aiming for similar sized holes. So like so. Okay, and we need to do the same for eye sockets. So again, poke him in the eye. Very typically, you can see all of the characters have their eyes actually meeting in the middle.
Yeah.
In a kind of figure
okay,
of eight.
So these...
we're making an eye socket. So go fairly deep again and put the two holes together so your eyeballs will actually
touch
as well. Beautiful.
Okay.
Excellent. So we have very that and we need a couple of creases on his nose. You can see we've got three lines running down there.
There we are.
So we can just pop those on again. Cocktail sticks will do all of this work for you, really. So one, two, three. So we're going to add a little bit of a pig smile as well. So
great.
You can use your cocktail stick, and it's tricky to shape, but if you kind of put the point in like so, and then rock the cocktail stick around like so, you can kind of give it a smile, make it go under the snout, and do it again on this
How
side.
How close would you do it to the tip of the nose?
You're sort of going underneath,
of
right?
That's
it,
going underneath, and try and make those two lines kind of
meet
up. There we go. So kind of giving it a bit of a cheeky smile.
Yeah.
Great.
Okay, so we have our kind of rat's tail pigtails.
Yeah.
What I would do is give them, bend them over on an angle like so.
Yeah.
And then give it a little bit of a corkscrew twist gently so we don't tear the clay, but we want a nice little piggy tail.
You did that so well, and you made it look easier than it is.
It's deceptively tricky, but a few bits of practice. Well, actually, no, you're a natural. Look at that. There we go. You're born to make pigtails.
Well, I wish
you couldn't make
the rest
pig's ears, but
was as good as my tail.
So we're going to put those on his bum, nice and perky on the top.
On the top, right.
Like that. Okay. So we've got a little bit of a curl to it. And again, tricky, so use the cocktail stick to blend that in. Now we've got our rolled leg clay, and we can just split that into four so we can fold it in half and twist.
Oh, this didn't go well
like
last
so.
Time.
And then fold it in half and twist again.
Exactly, you're all over this now.
Ah, here we go.
One, two, three, four. And that's the legs partially done. Now the legs are rather like a golf tee, so we can just push the ends down like so, and just give a little bit of a hoof shape to it. You can also roll it in your fingers to kind of give that nice golf tee shape. So it's kind of a very classic Aardman kind of rubber hose for a leg, and then nice cartoony shapes really. So I think we're going to revisit legs in a minute, but I think we want to pop some eyeballs in our pigs as well. So we've all got some white clay, really nice and simple.
Great.
Two tiny,
tiny bits,
balls of clay, roll them on your hands, like so. Now, you probably won't need as much as you think. I'm constantly making us
eyes. So you just divided a...
Take a little bit off and just pop that, if you can see that, just pop that in there. And if it's too big, obviously you can...
Revisit.
Okay, we're getting close now.
He's really starting to look a little bit more like Hognob.
Yeah, my guy's got flat eyes.
Oh.
Now, to really bring it to life, without losing the eyeballs, take two little tiny bits of clay, like so, little tiny...
To give him pupils.
And then put pupils in there.
Yeah.
Now, this is the bit where you have to be careful not to make him go cross-eyed.
Right.
Or slightly Marty Feldman, kind of.
Yeah.
Whoops, that's a bit big.
There we go. And that really changes the character. The bigger the pupil, the kind of cuter or the younger they'll look. So how are we doing with eyes? There we go. Look, this is
look at that.
Already
that's...
coming to life. So
all right.
This is mine.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yours, I think, we can all agree, is excellent.
Thank you very much.
Thank you. I think execution.
I'm rather liking the stern look on this, actually. He's got a coy grin, which I rather like.
Yeah.
A good set of ears as well. It's, and you've certainly embraced the funny and the thummy. I'm already laughing, so that's good.
good.
And Maisie, I think that's... Actually, I think
that's,
there's a career. I think
you were
showing your animation background.
But I think
there,
Maisie grew up right next to Ardman, so I think that's going in for Saturday practice.
It's kind of in the air,
absolutely,
in the ether.
Absolutely, yeah. Modelling clay.
I'm sorry. No, I think he looks rather forlorn. I don't think you should be
impressed, Hobnob.
Yeah, I think you've kind of captured an emotion in there. That's
you look quite
beautiful.
Surprised.
So hopefully that's given you a bit of a taster as to how much work goes into a puppet.
Yeah. Wow,
it's
really amazing.
Do consider a career in animation?
Yeah. Amazing.
Basically, that can you hold that up for everybody? That is.
I think we should show these probably to so everybody can get a good
view.
Yeah, I certainly show them to Nick and see.
Wrong side of the animation.
Hopefully, you've got an idea of what goes into making something like Hobnob and enjoyed us making our Hobnobs as well. The film comes out Friday, the 26th of January, so please do come along and watch it and grab yourself some clay and have a go at making your own Hobnob as well. Great. So, unfortunately, the guys ran out of time and have had to shoot off, but we still have a few things to do with our Hobnob, so we need a pair of teeth and some legs to complete the look. So I'm going to take you through that now, step by step, and you can finish yours in your own time as well. What we're going to do is take a little bit of white clay, and we're going to make little kind of tusk-like raindrop shapes for those nice little tusks on the side, and just pop a pair of those either side, like so. So just press those on, not too much, you don't want to squidge them. Make sure they're nicely stuck on. There's one. And here's the second one. Brilliant, so we've got a nice pair of tusks for our Hobnob, and then the all-important legs. Now, the legs are like a golf tee, and then for the hoof itself, tiny little piece of black, and we're just making a kind of toenail shape or crescent shape that we can lay on to the foot. And then you can use, again, the pointed end of the cocktail stick, and if you lay that onto the hoof like so, and then push it in and roll it underneath the foot, you open up a little triangular split in the hoof, and that'll give it a nice kind of natural look as well. And you can also dress that in by adding a little bit of texture with the cocktail stick as well. So we have four legs ready to go. Now we need to put some bones into our legs so we can actually stand up. So again, we're gonna take four cocktail sticks and pop those down the legs. Now this is the tricky bit. If you twist it with your thumb and finger, a bit like a drill bit, it should worm its way down the leg. So you have a little bit of stick poking out, and that's gonna then push into the pig body. Four legs ready to go on. So I would choose your two best legs to go on the front. And we just pin them into the body like so. Just make sure they're nicely attached. Right, make sure your pig can stand happily, so the time for adjustments before we get on to the final kind of dressing bit and add some texture to your Hobnob, a standing pig. Again, we're going to employ cocktail sticks to add a bit of texture, and we're just simply going to kind of rake the clay up into an interesting kind of shaggy haircut, and you can work your way all the way around in a direction and kind of help to knit those bits of clay together around the legs as well. Repeat all the way along until it looks like that, and you're done.